Recording Schumann Cello Concerto with LSO and Hans Graf was a bit of a dream come true because I've been playing this concerto for a number of years. Every single performance allowed me to enter a bit deeper in this very intricate romantic expression. One can understand this work as a set of chapters linking in a way his life story. And he wrote this towards the end of his life in Dusseldorf, and Opus 129. And through the piece, one can see the path that he's taken in his artistic and professional life. Throughout Robert Schumann's career, all his compositions, or almost all, had always a relationship with Clara Schumann, who was not only his beloved wife, but also an artistic companion. I love the music so much because it's really the essence of a romantic era and romantic expression. However, cellistically, I would say one of the most, if not the most difficult concerto to perform because it's just very uncellistic. However, the music itself is so intense, so varied. Cellistically, to try to convey this absolute fine nuances of expression, one needs to have a flawless technique and one needs actually to overcome the cellistic difficulties. So we need to have very, very fine dynamic ranges, and we need to have very fine, subtle nuances, subtle colors to express, passionate passages which needs to burst out of cello, and combining it all was a huge challenge, but also immensely satisfying. Hans is somebody I had been greatly admiring as a musician, as a conductor. I could see that he was incredibly generous, warm-hearted, and the most kind person.
You wouldn't believe that in my youth, some critics still say, oh, it was very well played, but it's not the strongest work. Dead wrong. It is the strongest work. And among cello players, it's the most beautiful, most challenging concerto. It's a very quiet CD, I think, and very well filled with emotions. And that's what I liked also with this orchestra, not just with the soloist, which was extraordinary, but with the orchestra, which is deemed and known as perfectionists and ready and slick. They are this, but they're also very soulful, very friendly, very individual. It was just astonishing how high the level and how smooth the work could be.
I learned so much just seeing him pacing the recording procedure and the way he talks to the musicians, the way he brings them to be attentive to his ideas. 6 intense sessions which were very, very warm and a friendly atmosphere.
Of course, he plays the cello extremely well, but the balance of the, what I would call the intellectual component, the intellectual preparation as well as the musical preparation is quite interesting. He has definite ideas, but he also is willing to go where the music takes him. I mean, we all can have wonderful ideas in our head and on paper, but when the music starts, the music carries us, and we have to go with that. I think the most important musical word is giusto, an Italian word that means right. You know it's right when you feel it. It doesn't matter what it says on paper. It just has to sound convincing, and that's something that I think Sung Won, he has both sides. He has the intellectual preparation, the musical preparation, and then his willingness to go with the music.
This Schumann Concerto will be released with Clara Schumann, 3 romances for violin and piano that was transcribed for me by a friend of mine. I played with Emmanuel Strosse, with whom I have played a number of concerts and I have recorded many recordings with. And also the Johannes Brahms clarinet trio was recorded with Emmanuel Strosse, with Han Kim, principal clarinet from Opéra National de Paris, a fantastic clarinetist. These 3 giants of Romantic era cannot be separated. One can hear very different textures, one can hear very different timbre of sounds. However, one can also witness the close relationships that they shared. How much Clara was encouraging, inspiring Robert, and how much Clara was important to young Brahms, how much of an important composer he's become thanks to Robert and also thanks to Clara. All this is very, very intriguing, and the mix of the 3 composers who loved and respected and inspired each other in the same recording is something which would be very meaningful to me. Performing so many times the Schumann Concerto and finally recording them with this absolutely fantastic orchestra and great conductor was a true joy, and I know I will look back on it with a great pride and also as an artistic stepping stone.